My brother-in-law says he uses peroxide, 1 cup to 1 gallon of water, to spray his tomatoes for blight. We started using copper per your recommendation, but peroxide would be cheaper. What do you think? Does copper fungicide or peroxide work better? This is Geneva in Brighton, Tennessee. So what do you think? Copper fungicide or peroxide? I wouldn't use peroxide.
I would not use peroxide. I know for one, it's not labeled.
It's not labeled, right.
And you're eating these tomatoes. Mm-hmm. And you know, H2O2 is what peroxide mm-hmm. is. So it, you know, I don't think I would do that. I don't know, you know, I don't know that it has, you know, antifungal properties at all, but it.
Ask a question, Adam.
It might. I would, but I, the fungicides that we recommend for blight control in tomatoes in Tennessee are chlorothalonil or mancozeb. And you can kind of mix those up. One at a time, but I probably would not use the same fungicide.
Rotate them
around a little bit. Yeah. But for tomatoes, stick with the old
chlorothalonil
or mancozeb. I think you'll be all right, and you won't have to be worried about eating the fruit from them either. Because you've got to control blight, you've got to spray when you've got ripe fruit out there on the plant.
We hope you enjoyed the video. We have hundreds more. To subscribe, just click below.